All right, while we're sitting in here washing dishes, Maria and I decided to write a little song for you. Right, Maria? You ready?
Yeah.
You just wash the dishes and dance while I sing the song.
Okay. Ready?
Here we go. We're washing dishes and we're having some fun. We're gonna dry when the washing is done. And then we're gonna put the dishes away. That's what we do on a dishwashing day. We're washing dishes. Soapy, 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 soapy dishes. Grab yourself a washcloth or maybe a sponge. Come on, let's have some dishwashing fun. We're washing dishes.
We're with the Chapmans. That's the late Maria Sue. It's hard to say that. We're going to go to calls and emails for this group. Email question from Priscilla in White Marsh, Maryland. We'll have Mary Beth try this. Have you gotten mad at God because of this? Have you asked God why your family? Why Maria?
Yep. I've been mad. I've been sad. I've jumped up and down. I've crawled under my bed. I've went in my closet. You name it, I've done it. And I know that I will never understand this side of eternity. Why Maria? Why Will? I mean, I have a list of questions in my journal, you know, why? So to answer that question, yeah, I've been really angry.
Never anger at Will?
Never.
We have a caller. We'll go to Carrollton, Kentucky. Hello.
Yes. Hello?
Hello, hi. Go ahead.
Hi, my question is, first of all, I wanted to say that the song Cinderella, me and my two daughters love to listen to that song, and I just wanted to ask the Chapman family if it is difficult for them to listen to that song now.
Is it hard, Caleb?
I remember I play guitar for my dad, and so after all this went down, we all questioned, are we ever going to go back out on the road? Are we ever going to be able to play music again, because that's something that just reminds us of joy, and Maria was so much of that joy. And so we ended up getting back out on the road, and I remember we all dreaded that song in the set. It was like, Dad told us we might not do it. I'm just gonna have to see when the show comes. I'm just gonna have to see if it feels right. And the song prior to it kind of just led him into Cinderella real naturally. And of course, it was so tough hearing it because the lyrics are, the clock will strike midnight and she'll be gone. And so, yeah, it was tough, but Dad ended the song and I didn't know he's gonna do this. And instead of ending it, the clock will strike midnight and she'll be gone, he said, the clock will strike midnight, but the truth is the dance will go on and that he'll dance with his daughter again, so.
So you still play it, Stephen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You ought to be very proud of this.
No, I'm sure.
By the way, they've all been, for some reason, except for Emily, tattooed in memory of Maria,
the
right?
The cat is out of the bag.
Yours is on your wrist.
Yeah, yeah.
You won't show you. Right. I guess yours is. Want to show yours, Caleb?
There she is.
Mm-hmm.
Right on his arm.
Written in his arm.
Ooh. And there's Will with the...
He's got the big M on his chest.
Yeah.
An email from Kelvin in Gastonia, North Carolina. A lot of people might ask how a good and loving God could allow the kind of pain your family is enduring. How would you respond? Stephen, why would he allow it?
That's a great, great question, and one that we have all wrestled with, and I've absolutely wrestled with. And by saying that, you know, I haven't been angry at God, I've been real angry. My anger has really been aimed at the one who, I understand, has, the Bible says, has come to steal, kill, and destroy, the enemy of God, Satan. But if you've ever read the book of Job, you know that somehow God allows things. I believe God allows evil. He doesn't crush everything that's evil, or who of us could stand before him if we've ever had any evil thing in our life.
This wasn't evil.
Well, but what happened was what happened to my daughter, I believe, was evil, that she died in the driveway of my house. But my anger has been aimed at the one who I believe ultimately destroys and kills, the enemy of God. Why did God allow it? I believe God was there. I believe God had tears in his eyes. I believe God weeps over death. Jesus wept at the death, at the grave of Lazarus. In the Bible, Jesus weeps at death. I don't think we'll ever know. Caleb said something at the memorial service for Maria about how we're looking at a picture, a painting, so close. And sorry to steal this, Caleb, but you have your permission, son. I probably taught it to you somewhere anyway, and then you pass it back. No. But he was talking about how we look, you know, sometimes at a painting, a huge mural, and if we're looking this close, it makes no sense. And as we move it back further and further, we begin to see what's happening, what's going on there. And again, there's a million theological questions. If Billy Graham stays with us, our dear friend, let's let him come back and help tackle this one. But I believe with all my heart, or I wouldn't sit here, I wouldn't be foolish enough to drag my family here and us sit here and say we still have faith and believe.
You because, obviously do.
Because we believe that God, for some reason, with tears, with great grief in his own heart over evil, allowed this. But, and we'll understand it someday when we see our sweet Maria again.
The Chapmans are speaking publicly about something that's very private. We'll ask them why they're letting us in on their lives when we come back.
Weight of the world on my shoulders. It's been a long day and there's still work to do. So I dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms. 'Cause I know something the prince never knew. Oh, I dance with Cinderella. I don't want to miss even one song. 'Cause all too soon the clock will strike midnight and she'll be gone.
We're back with the Chapmans. Before we get to some more calls and emails, why, Stephen, speak out? Why? This is a very personal, terrible tragedy. Yeah. One could make a case for just going away and hiding.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and at first that's what we did. And yeah, yeah, we all. And my biggest fear, honestly, doing all this, Larry, is that, you know, this is kind of what I do. I've been doing this for 21 years as far as performing and being in front of cameras or in front of audiences. And my biggest fear with this is just, even my prayer today is, God, I just don't want to be on. I don't want to, like, sit there and all of a sudden be Stephen Curtis Chapman, the performer. And, you know, just let us be honest and just real about this journey. And
why do you want to go on?
The reason for that is, you know, and we read it before we came out here again today, I think the word of comfort, we realize one of my first thoughts when this happened, we had just come back from China. In fact, we were sitting in the Shanghai airport in China when the earthquake hit. We didn't feel it, but we do a lot of work in China with orphans, and we had been there doing some of that work, and we were on our way home. We got home and started to hear the numbers of how many had died. We'd just been with our friends there, and our hearts were broken. And even as we were in the emergency room grieving the immediate news of Maria going to heaven, I immediately thought of the people of China, and I thought, we have a comfort. We don't have words. We don't have an explanation, as we've fumbled over trying to explain how, why, all that. But we do have a comfort, and we do have a hope, and we feel like we want to share it. There are a lot of people suffering.
Because you're being seen in Beijing now.
Yeah.
Everywhere in the... All right. I guess I understand. Colonial Heights, Virginia. Hello.
Hello, Mr. King. And I just want to tell the Chapman family my heartfelt condolences to your family, and that the Lord must have so much faith in your family to know that you can bear this. And I just want to ask you, when you've had time to grieve and heal, do you think you will adopt again?
Oh boy, that's a little touchy question there, because our time in China, Mom sort of found some twins that she fell in love with, and
you're
right
kidding.
Now we got a little debate going on about that.
You want to bring them home?
If it was that easy, yes. If it was that easy, yes. But
there's a lot of
questions. Would you think if you had twin little sisters?
If it's supposed to happen, I'm all for it. So
good answer. Good boy. There is a politician.
Will.
That's crazy, but I don't know. Like Caleb said, if it's right, I guess it's right. But I don't know.
You got a big enough house?
Yes.
Sure.
Yeah.
We've all doubled.
The more the merrier.
We have enough. We just go back.